In this video, I'll try to decode money market in a very simple manner. Let's start. If you are following my videos, in my last videos, I have explained what is financial market. So financial market basically two types. One is money market, second one is capital market. In my last two videos, I have explained this particular part. Today, I'll focus on this part very deeply. What is money market? In my last video, I have told you that money market, it's like a, so if financial transaction happen less than, in money market, financial transaction happen less than 1 year. Normally, in money market, financial transaction happen for the shorter period of time. So we need to think like this, it's for shorter period of time. Say for example, minimum maybe 1 day to 1 year. Okay. Now, if I go to money market, basically it is risk wise, it is low risk. Okay. Cost wise, it is low cost. Liquidity wise, it is high liquidity. It has high liquidity. Now, return wise, it has low return. Okay. So, that is why most of the big organization like Reserve Bank of India, Government of India, State Bank of India, different banks, when they need money for shorter period of time to park means to lend or to borrow, they go for money market. Money market basically two types. One is organized segment, second one is unorganized segment. So what is organized segment? So organized segment is nothing but, so this particular segment actually, in this particular segment, participation happen through Reserve Bank of India, State Bank of India, associate banks, public sector bank, private sector commercial bank, foreign banks, regional rural banks, non-scheduled commercial bank, life insurance corporation, general insurance corporation, United Trust of India, these big players of entire financial industry. So they comes under organized segment. Then who comes under unorganized segment? Then indigenous bankers, then money lenders, then non-banking financial intermediaries such as chit funds, then your local person who lend you money. So this comes under unorganized segment. Clear? Now let's try to understand what are the money market instruments. So money market instruments are like government securities, G-Sec, then T-bill, then call money, then intra-bank term deposit. So these are example of money market. Okay. Now let's understand who regulates this particular money market. So RBI or central bank of any country, they actually regulate this particular money market. Okay. So as we discussed, bank and most of the banks are the major player of money market. So that is why globally all the central bank of different developed economy, they came together and maintained a common norms. Nowadays it is called Basel norms. Most of the bank maintain Basel norms. This is one bank. Okay. And you, me, वी डिड एफडी, एफडी और थ्रू सेविंग्स बैंक वी डिपॉजिटेड मनी टू दिस पर्टिकुलर बैंक. क्लियर. नाउ दिस डिपॉजिट बैंक विल यूटिलाइज बाय गिविंग लोन. क्लियर. सो ऑल दिस शॉर्ट टर्म लोन, शॉर्ट दिस लोन कैन बी गिवेन टू इंडिविजुअल्स लाइक यू एंड मी, कॉर्पोरेट्स लाइक अनदर बैंक. दिस इज कॉल्ड इंट्रा बैंक. ओके. और गवर्नमेंट एक्सेट्रा. ओके. इट कैन बी शॉर्ट टर्म लोन, इट कैन बी लॉन्ग टर्म लोन. क्लियर. सो इफ इट इज लाइक शॉर्ट टर्म लोन, दिस एक्टिविटी हैपेंस शॉर्ट टर्म, सो मिनिमम वन डे टू वन ईयर, देन इट कम्स अंडर मनी मार्केट. ओके. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इट कम्स अंडर मनी मार्केट. क्लियर. नाउ बैंक हैज 100 रुपीज, सो कैन बैंक गिव 100 रुपीज लोन? नो. फॉर दैट रीजन बैंक ऑल द रेगुलेटरीज, सो से फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन इंडिया दिस मनी मार्केट रेगुलेट्स बाय आरबीआई. ओके. सो आरबीआई इश्यू टू रेशियोज, वन इज SLR, okay, statutory liquid ratio, okay, SLR, statutory liquid ratio, and CRR, cash reserve ratio, okay. So in this by this ratio, so RBI will decide how much percentage they can give loan to others. How much percentage of what? Deposit. How much percentage of deposit? Say for example, if RBI says you can give only 80% of your deposit as a loan, then they will give 80% of their deposit as a loan. Clear? Now you understood what is SLR, what is CRR, what is the purpose of that? Okay. Now let's understand money market instrument by example. What is call money? Okay. So next is note money. Third is term money. So what is call money? Call money means if deposit is deposit period maximum one day or overnight, okay, then it is called call money. Okay. So if it is, and this is like all the day except Sunday or any holidays. Okay. Now note money. Note money is, so this particular deposit is for more than one day to 15 days. Clear? Now comes term money. Term money, this particular deposit is for more than 15 days. Clear? Now let's understand what is the interest of money market. How to calculate the interest of money market? So first is amount So amount which you have lent or borrowed, clear, into what number of days. Say for example you have borrowed for 30 days divided by 365. Okay, why? Because of we need to make it accrual yearly basis, into rate of interest, rate of interest divided by 100. So this is how we need to calculate interest on money market. Clear? So if it is term money, then interest calculation may happen quarterly or half yearly or yearly. Till now it is clear? Now let's discuss one different type of money market instrument which corporates or business they use very often. That is called bill of discount, or we can say bill discount. Okay, this is also one very short term instrument, and it has a very interesting concept. Say for example there is one buyer and one seller. Okay, so what buyer does, he gave order, seller transfer goods. Okay, now buyer has to transfer him what? Cash. But instead of transferring cash, what buyer will do? Buyer will issue him something called credit note to seller. Now say for example in this credit note buyer told ki he will pay him after 90 days. Clear? Now seller after 30 days he need money. After 30 days he saw he need money. Okay, then what he can do right now, he can go to a bank. Okay, and say for example this particular transaction happened of 100 rupees. So seller right now he has credit note of 100 rupees. Okay, so she can go, actually seller can go to bank and ask for immediate cash. Okay, so he can go along with this credit note CR, he can go to bank and submit the CR and ask the bank, so I have 100 rupees of CR, instead of 100 rupees you give me 80 rupees. Okay, so what happened ki immediately seller's cash liquidity issue got resolved. Correct? Now banker after 90 days he will go to buyer after 90 days, okay, and ask for the money, and buyer will transfer 100 rupees to banker. Okay, so what this particular bank has done, 100 minus 80, 20 rupees profit, because he gave money earlier to seller. So that is how bank did his profit. This concept is called bill discount. Bill discount normally happen. Bill discount normally happens 60 days to for 60 days to 180 days. Clear? Treasury bill. So Reserve Bank of India normally issue this treasury bill. This is short term in nature. Risk wise, it is low risk. It will give you some maturity date. Okay, maturity date, prefix date it is. In this particular maturity date, they will give you some amount. Now there is something called issuing date. In this particular date, actually they issue by some particular amount. Difference between these two amounts is the profit or return. Clear?